track and field update here approaching the end of May. Still got some athletes going in track and field this spring, and a successful weekend out in California.
Yeah, I would say it was really, really successful when you look at not only the people that went on to qualify for the final round in Austin, Texas, but just how they performed, at the meet. I think, we can be really, really proud of what we did. And that's the one thing that we did ask our student athletes is that, it certainly everybody wants to make it, keep the season going. But if you can come in and, exceed where you're seated, be close to a personal best or set personal best, then, you can leave the meet holding your head high. And with, a fair number, some seniors involved in this, knowing this is probably their, last high-level competition, there are a lot of different emotions that, play out for them, and, they handled it really well, and, really, really proud of the effort of the group in Sacramento.
You talked a little bit off camera, but really impressive from the 4x100 men's relay team to get to that next level, getting under 40 seconds, a school record, obviously.
Yeah, when you look at sub 40 seconds, and that's very, very impressive. And you look at track and field history at SDSU, and certainly haven't been noted as doing a lot of things in the sprints or even the relays, whether it be a 4x1 or 4x4. Talking that maybe late 90s at the Division II level, we had a 4x4 team highlighted by Jason Harris, or you go back to 1983 or 84 with the Gebharts and Tiefenthaler and that kind of group. Historically, we just haven't been great. And then to have this happen with a 4x1 team, and certainly with Baylor and TCU, for whatever reason, not getting to the starting line, and then Houston dropping the baton, the relay gods were definitely smiling on the Jackrabbits that afternoon. And it doesn't matter. We're going. The boys punch a ticket, and they extend their season, survive in advance. Every basketball cliche is out there for these guys. And it's great because, they came into the meet relaxed. There can't be a higher pressure situation than trying to get the baton around at a regional qualifying meet. And it showed. They, Coach Hannenberger had them ready, and they got it done. And, a victory lap, I guess they'll get to perform in Austin. And, it's going to be a lot of high pressure there, too, in the prelims. If they can get it around cleanly, run a little bit faster, maybe they move into a situation where one of the top 16 teams in the country. And, obviously very, very cool. So, very proud of those young men.
Rachel King advances to the championships second year in a row for her. 9:50 was her time, won the third heat.
Yeah, she ran a smart race, did what she had to do, held back enough to make sure that she had enough to finish, and then finished with a really strong last lap to sneak by Charlotte Prowse in New Mexico for the win. And the win's not, super important. The advancing was important. PR, really close to the USA National Track and Field qualifying time, which would be in Des Moines in late July, which I'm somewhat confident that mark will get her in. And, just impressive. The pressure of that situation, especially when you're supposed to go, doesn't get any easier. And she handled it very, very well. And, excited about the prospects of what she can do in Austin. So, an incredible career continues, and, it's something that certainly I think, our coaching staff will cherish, because an athlete like that does not come around very often.
A few others were close to advancing as well. Kyle Burdick and Trent Francombe just a few inches away for him as well.
Yeah, Trent opened up. He was clean over the first three bars. So it made 17-1, hadn't really missed it, and then the weather turned a little foul, and a lot of time in between jumps, and gets to the next bar and just can't quite get over it, over the bar, but just landing on top of it. He makes that bar, he's in the NCAAs, which would have been an incredible accomplishment as well. He's had a great year. It would have been, awesome for him to get to that next level, because he's definitely a guy that's going to be an 18-foot vaulter before he's done. and doing some really, really cool things that haven't been seen here. For Kyle Burdick, end of a incredible career. And I thought both of his races that he ran in the 1500 were tactically some of the best that he's run in college in the, what would be the quarterfinal round, or the, you know, the round that, you know, he needed to, you know, be in the top five or to, you know, be one of those two-time qualifiers. He was in a perfect position, just couldn't finish the deal out. You know, still runs the second fastest time ever. And, but, you know, in terms of where we wanted to be in the race, tactically he was right where he needed to be, and just, you know, didn't happen. So I don't think there's as many if, woulda, coulda, shouldas, or if, ands, and buts. He just didn't quite have enough on that day. But, you know, number of Summit League titles and being an NCAA American, I think when you talk about maximizing, you know, abilities and all that sort of stuff, Kyle Burdick definitely did that, and we're very appreciative of him for coming back for, you know, a fifth year and doing so much for our program, both in cross country, indoor and outdoor track. So
the championships will be middle of next week, June 5th through the 8th. How do you get the athletes ready for the middle of next week?
Well, I think for Rachel, you know, the good thing is, I mean, she's been through this before, and you know, certainly it's a tough time of year. I mean, it was, you know, it gets tough at regionals when a lot of people are, you know, teammates are gone and that sort of thing. And now, particularly her cross country teammates are already starting their ramp up for the cross country season. But, you know, for her, I think, you know, there's a level of confidence that comes with, okay, I've lowered my PR again by 7 seconds. You know, I'm sitting, you know, at a decent level. It's hard to compare the East and West regions because of differences in weather. So she'll have to be ready to advance to the final, but certainly that's going to be the goal, get to the final. Once you get in the final, then, you know, the goal would be obviously get on the podium, but got to get to that final first. And, you know, dealing with Austin heat and humidity will be something that we'll, you know, look at some different aspects here in the next 5-6 days to try and get ready for that. And, you know, confident that she's, you know, still got a bit more run in her. And, you know, again, the goal is trying to get on that podium. And with the 4x1, you know, kind of talked about that it's, you know, just executing. You know, when they qualified last week, they did it out of lane 8, which is not the most ideal lane in the world. You know, probably nothing comes easy for this group, and I think that's the way they would like it. But you know, maybe a little bit better lane, they maybe have a little bit better opportunity to run faster. And you know, again, if they can get it around clean and, you know, really good handoffs, you know, I think it's capable that they could run a little bit faster, especially if it's warmer. Sacramento wasn't overly warm. So yeah, excited, you know, for that group. You know, it's just super exciting. And that'll help Rachel too, to have, you know, those guys down there. You know, more the merrier and that sort of thing. So it's really good. And, you know, again, as an exhibition of how hard it is, these are the only people on the track in the Summit League that qualified. And when you look back to last year, I believe Rachel's the only one on the track that qualified. So it's very, very difficult to get into the NCAA finals. And, you know, a huge accomplishment. And, you know, for the other folks we didn't really talk about as much, Logan Ammons, Oksana Covey, and Cal Lawton. You know, Logan exceeded his expectations, you know, at the regional meet. Didn't throw a PR, but again, the pressure of that situation, you know, not everyone throws PRs. There's lucky sometimes to come close to those, and he was close, and I thought threw well. Cal Lawton, you know, ended up being the first guy out of the, from advancing to the next round. You know, just ran off his PR, and thought that, you know, tactically ran a perfect race. Again, just didn't have enough gas in the tank to last, you know, probably 30 meters where he advances. Oksana, you know, good year to recover from a really tough injury the year before. Unfortunately, her feet kind of failed her a little bit here at the last minute, but great year for her, and she is somebody who will be back as well. So, again, you know, a great weekend, I think, for our group, and a lot of excitement still ahead for, you know, our track and field program here at South Dakota State.